you may have seen the headlines about the Earth spinning faster than normal after it recorded its shortest day ever, at least since scientists have been keeping record, that is. On June 29, the Earth completed a full rotation 1.59 milliseconds, less than the usual 24 hours.
For the everyday person, that's hard to comprehend how that could make any impact at all, but scientists are warning the effects could be devastating. To explain what it all means, we're joined by astrophysicist Matt Agnew from Melbourne. Matt, good morning to you. Astrophysicists like yourself are monitoring this sort of thing all the time. Did you expect this? Did the scientific world know this was coming? I mean, what's caused it all?
Look, yes and no. So the Earth is on a long time scale slowing down. And if you go back to kind of the time of the dinosaurs, the Earth span about half an hour shorter. Days are only 23 and a half hours. So it's surprising in that way, but in the last couple of years, there's been a number of days where the Earth has spun faster. And so the previous record before this particular one was back in 2020 in June. It was 1.49 milliseconds faster. So it's a yes and no. It's odd that it's spinning faster, but it has happened in the past.
But Matt, we're talking about 1.59 milliseconds. So why does it matter?
So on a day-to-day, it's fairly insignificant. It's kind of, these numbers are quite hard to get your head around, but it's kind of the same scale as if you put a quarter of a cup of water in an Olympic-sized swimming pool. That's the kind of effect 1.59 milliseconds has on a day-to-day. The thing is, if it keeps happening day-to-day, year-to-year, and keeps accumulating, that's where you get things where, you know, clocks start getting thrown out of whack and no longer aligning with what's happening between our clocks and the Earth and the day.
Well, I was going to make a joke about our clocks and whether our phones would automatically adjust for us, like daylight savings. But what about like atomic clocks, like the ones that actually are used to track time? Mm.
Yeah, so the atomic clocks are rock solid. These are our kind of gold standard of timekeeping. And that's kind of what tells us whether or not the Earth is spinning faster or slower, how things are out of sync with atomic clocks. So we can use the atomic clock... Let me say that again. We can use the atomic clocks to determine, okay, the Earth spun faster. Do we need to adjust our UTC, Universal Time, which is kind of Greenwich Mean Time? And, yeah, we can use them to help calibrate things. But the problem is how that will be calibrated and what implications that can have.
So we have no idea whether this is likely to happen again?
It's probably going to happen again because the underlying thing that's causing this, which they don't know for sure, but it's likely to be something related to really long timescales, you know, things like the ocean and the atmosphere sloshing around the Earth, the internal molten core of the Earth sloshing around. These things happen over a long timescale. They don't kind of start and stop abruptly. So it's likely this will happen again, but it's also likely that it will eventually stop in the coming few years and revert back to the Earth slowing down.
I'm going to level with you, Matt. I don't like the idea of a molten core sloshing around.
No.
That worries me slightly, but appreciate your time this morning. Thank you.
Absolute pleasure. Thank you.